quick, Harry.
You cannot drink, Captain.
Luke's Grove can't see anything, please, Cabby.
Yes.
Gentleman to see you, Doctor.
Is it an urgent matter?
I don't know, Doctor.
Well, did he give you his card?
No, Doctor.
Ivy, if I've told you once, I've told you 100 times, my consulting hours are plainly displayed outside. Now, please.
Oh, sir.
Dr. Watson.
Yes, indeed, sir. You may go, Ivy. I am exceedingly busy, sir.
Yeah, of course you are, Doctor. Of course you are a man of considerable responsibilities. But I heard you give your address to that cab driver outside the court, and I said to myself, I'll just hobble around and see that kind gentleman. I have a conscience. And tell him that if I was a little gruff in my manner, I meant no harm by it, and I'm much obliged to him for helping me pick up my books.
You make too much of a trifle, sir. You should have spared yourself the journey. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Oh, no great journey, sir.
I am a neighbor of yours. You will find my little bookshop on the corner of Church Street. May I sit down? Very happy to see you, I'm sure, Doctor. Perhaps
you collect?
I have the British birds, Catullus, and quite a rare volume of the Holy War. Bargains, every one of them. Just the books you need to fill up your bookcase. Give it a little weight. It does look a little untidy, does it not?
Watson, do you mind if I smoke a cigarette in your consulting room?